Alright. Trying to get you in a good position. I hope the lighting's okay, guys. It's a beautiful cloudy fall day out, so I hope the lighting is okay for y'all. I have a light over here to try to, you know, get better lighting, because it is very cloudy out, but it is a gorgeous fall day. I love it. Happy day, everybody! Welcome back to my channel, Dante James. I'm, of course, Dante James, and if it is Wednesday and it is noon, that means it's lunch with Dante. If you're new here, every Wednesday we have lunch. At noon Eastern Standard Time, we have lunch, we discuss stuff. I don't really call it a mukbang, but, you know, I eat, and we just discuss stuff. Sometimes I do challenges, sometimes I don't. It just all depends, but Wednesday noon, Eastern Standard Time, here we are. So, guys, before we get started, a couple things real quick. Anyway, you know, I just wanted to say we had a great anniversary weekend. This weekend was our 5th wedding anniversary, so it was very nice. We just stayed home. We were gonna go on a day trip and you know, we just decided to stay home and relax and enjoy and just enjoy the fall weather, take the pups for a, you know, I don't want to say it out loud because they're right here. So guys, another thing I wanted to bring up is if you noticed on Saturday, I did not post a challenge. I just wanted to enjoy the weekend. I didn't film a challenge last week. I do have a bunch that I'm challenged in though. I do have the Hot Mama Pickle one that I'm going to be doing. Probably you'll see that this Saturday. And then I have a ravioli one to do and a seaweed one to do. But guys, I always post my challenges on Saturday. So if you do challenge me, I do write it down and you'll just see it on that Saturday. I call them like Challenge Saturdays now. And of course, my special videos on Fridays and Sundays at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So anyway, guys, also I wanted to say with the challenges, guys, I love that you challenge me. It's so much fun. The challenges are really great. But one thing is, don't challenge me if it involves like ruining food. I don't want to go out, spend my money on food that I'm just gonna throw in the trash. I don't like that. I don't wanna do challenges where I'm ruining food. Food is expensive, especially now in these times, and I'm flattered that you challenge me. I love when you guys challenge me, but if it involves me ruining food just to throw it out, not happening. Like, I was challenged too, and it was no offense to the creator of this challenge, no offense to the person that challenged me at all, but I was challenged to the green peanut nut green challenge where you put peanut butter on vegetables. That just seemed like I was ruining the vegetables. I did not do that one. I don't want to throw out perfectly good vegetables. So that's basically it. If you want to challenge me to the pickle one, the ravioli one, even the seaweed one, I'll do that one. No big deal. But I just don't want to do challenges where I'm throwing away food and like basically ruining it to the point that I'm not gonna eat it. So that's just it. So with all of that aside, guys, if you noticed last week in my coming out story video, I didn't comment back to any of y'all. I did not comment back to any of y'all because I wanted to read your comments here and respond to them in a video, in a Lunch with Dante. I know some of y'all love when I respond to your videos in kind of live action, so I wanted to do that. So that's what we're gonna do today. I'm gonna respond to all of them. I'm gonna pop them up on the screen here, and I'm going to verbally respond to everybody and their comments, because the comments on that video were really great, and I wanna shout out all of y'all that commented, and like I said, verbally be able to answer them. For lunch today, guys, I have a yummy salad. We made salad last night with we made pork loin salad and white rice, and this salad was so delicious that I saved it for today, because I was so excited. We have more salad in there to make, but this is what was left over from last night, so I was like, I'm gonna save this and have it in my Lunch with Dante, because y'all, it's gonna be coming up in a future video, but this dressing right here, look at that golden yumminess. I'm gonna be sharing this recipe with y'all in a future video, so look for that. But this salad dressing is delicious, and a little goes a long way, so I'm gonna be sharing that with all of y'all in a future video. So let me just dressing up my salad, mix it around. Oh, and this lettuce, guys, oh my goodness, this salad was so delicious last night. I had more salad last night than I did of the pork loin, because this was just so delicious. Hold on, I'll give you a little bite. Ooh, the lettuce seems okay. It held up overnight, but you know, it's still okay. Mm.
Mmm, so, so good.
Okay, guys, let's get to some comments.
Let me just pull them up. I have my iPad. And I was so happy
to share my story with all of y'all. Everybody's coming out, every person's coming out story is different, so I just wanted to share mine with all of y'all. Mmm.
Just dressing.
It's fabulous. It's not my recipe, but I'll explain all that in a future video. You guys probably won't see it, not this weekend, but next weekend. So I'm super excited. I'm filming it this week, but I have my last two Halloween videos coming out. So you guys will see it next weekend. It's gonna be a cooking with Dante.
Hey.
So I'm just gonna go right from the top and just go down. The first comment is from Aslapino Jalapeno. I love her. Hi, Ashley. I love her. I just watched her the other day. I just watched her do like a Libra video where she was talking all about Libras and the sign and all of that. And I found it so interesting because JB's a Libra and all the stuff she said was so interesting and so on point. It was so on point with who a Libra is. It was so amazing. Aslapino Jalapeno said, Dante, thank you for sharing your story. This is a great inspiration to so many. Proud of you for being so brave at such a young age. You'd be a great mentor for kids who are trying to navigate and understand their identity and sexuality. Also, I didn't realize that you and Dee's daughter were childhood besties. That's awesome. Also, your pasta is, she put that emoji. I love good, simple, creamy, peppery pasta. Yes, Ashley, thank you so much for commenting. That is, that. In all honesty, when I was younger, that was kind of like a dream of mine. It kind of still is that I'd love to, like you said, help kids or teens navigate their identity and their sexuality. And I always wanted to do that. I was actually just talking to Angelina about that. Yes, me and Angelina are childhood friends. And I always wanted to do that. I was actually just talking to Angelina about that a couple weeks ago when she was over, talking about, you know, having a kind of youth group or an LGBTQ plus group where you can help teens or kids that are, you know, just trying to find themselves. And I would love that. Love that. That has always been a dream of mine. And my pasta was very delicious. I loved it. Oh my God. But today I'm having my salad. Today I'm having my salad. But thank you so much for commenting, Ashley. That was a really nice comment. Thank you so much. Next up is D Diets. Hi, D. So D commented, I absolutely love the story and it made my heart feel so happy when you said you came out to Angelina first. That shows such comfort with a friend and I love you just the way you are. Wouldn't want you any other way. And you are living your true self and everybody loves you and honestly, it doesn't make a difference. I always say it's the content of someone's character that I want to get to know, not what goes on behind closed doors. Oh my goodness, it's 5 years. It's 5 years in your anniversary. Well, happy anniversary, the two of you. To the two of you, and on a side note, I absolutely love that spaghetti dish. I ate that a lot. I could have it. And I love that you and that picture of you and Angelina when you were both so young. It's so nice to have such a trusted friend. And by the way, I was having my granola as I was watching this video, so that was my lunch. Although your lunch looks so much better. D, I just watched your granola video this morning and I want to eat it so bad. I need to follow your recipe and make it. What a healthy, I love granola, I love oats. I have to do that. And it's weird that you posted that video because I've been wanting to buy oats. So it's weird that you posted that because I've been wanting to buy and eat more healthy. I'm trying to eat more healthy. I would like to eat more healthy.
My salad.
But yes, Dee, you are so correct in that, and I completely agree with you. It is about, you should always get to know the person, get to know the content of a person, like you said, and get to know them, and who cares what they do in their bedroom? Who cares what they do in their behind closed doors? It's none of your business. It's about getting to know the core of a person, you know, having a great friend like you, like Angelina. You know, I love you both, and I'm so lucky and blessed to have you guys as friends. And yes, Angelina was the first one I ever came out to, and thank you so much for commenting, Dee, and I love you so, so much, my friend, and you know that. You definitely know that, and I'm gonna be having some granola, and maybe my next lunch with Dante, I'm gonna be having some of that granola you made. I'm gonna make it myself, and maybe next week for lunch with Dante, I'm gonna have some granola. I'm so excited, because that looked delicious. I'm so excited. But yes, that it was our anniversary. Like I said, we had a great time. But Dee, thank you so much for commenting. I love you so much, and you know that.
And there's a comment
under Dee's. Aw, Dee, you are a super sweet lady. Yes, she is. It was commented by Cooking with Judy Caldwell. Aw, Dee, you are a super sweet lady. Yes, Dee is. I love her so, so much. She knows I do. The next one is from Mitch Love Eat ASMR. Love the pasta and storytelling time. L23, just be yourself. God bless you. Thank you so much. Mitch Love Eat ASMR. I try to be myself every day. This is not a facade. This is who I am. You know, I always say that in my videos. Sometimes I am hyped up and maybe a little bit of a tweaked upper or heightened version of myself. But otherwise, this is me. This is who I am. I don't try to put on an act or a facade, or I just want to make people laugh, make people feel good. So yes, I'm just being myself. Next one is from my love, Gracie Lou Bargain Guru. I just love your coming out story. So happy that everyone was so accepting. You are very lucky, my friend. Love you. I love you too, Gracie Lou. And I was very lucky. I still am very lucky. If you don't like me, then shoo, I don't care. Okay, next one is from, and I love you, Gracie Lou, thank you for commenting. Okay, next one is R&A Legacy, great story, man, very brave, and thank you for sharing your personal side of the story. Thank you so much, R&A Legacy. Yes, I just wanted to share my story with y'all. It was National Coming Out Day. I figured, what a great topic to talk about in my lunch with Dante, and you guys get to know me a little better, and why not? You know, I was very lucky to have a really positive story. I was very lucky.
The salad.
Next one is Cooking with Judy Caldwell. Thanks for the taste of pasta. It's my favorite. Also, glad you did come out. We all have still so much love for you. Oh, thank you, Judy. I love you so much. And I know that all y'all love me. And I love all of y'all. I hope you feel that. I hope all of y'all feel that when you watch my videos. I love and appreciate every single one of you. I said that in my questions challenge video, that my biggest thing with YouTube is I got to meet all of y'all. And now we're all friends and it's so much fun. And you guys get to know me and I get to know you. And it's just so much fun. I love it. But thank you so much, Judy. Lady Luck, thank you for sharing your this story with us. No problem, Lady Luck. Like I said, I wanted you guys to get to know me better. Mama Vapes Beauty, hi Beth. Oh my gosh, happy early anniversary. This is an awesome video. Thanks for sharing, love you. I love you, Beth, and you know I love you. But thank you so much. And guys, thank you so much for watching it and listening. Ooh, I didn't realize how many comments are on this video. See, I told you, I didn't comment back. Next one is from Veggie Pals. I love my Veggie Pals. Happy day, Dante. I'm finally here. Your pasta looks incredible. I'm going to have to make that. I hope you are feeling better. Stomach bugs are the worst. Wouldn't it be great if one day in the near future we lived in a world where coming out would no longer be necessary? Wouldn't that be great, Amy? I so wish that time was now. So do I. Look at you and Angelina. I know we were just little babies at the bowling alley. Happy anniversary to you and JB. I wish you both a lifetime of love and happiness. I loved hearing your beautiful story. We love you bunches. And I love all of you bunches. You got you Veggie Pals know I love y'all bunches. You are so close to my heart. I love y'all so, so much. So, so much. I look forward to Wednesdays, Fridays, and Sundays when I get to watch yous. I look forward to it. I can't wait to see what yous are doing for Halloween. I'm so excited. But I love y'all so much. And Amy, I do agree. I wish we all lived in a world where that didn't happen. Hopefully in my lifetime, I'll see it. Hopefully. But we'll see.
The next one is
from Rome's Eating and Conversations. Great story. Thanks for sharing it with us. And happy early anniversary. Thank you so much, Rome's Eating and Conversations. Kicking it with Lynn. Hi, Lynn.
Lynn said, that looks
good. Live in your truth and live your best life. You are so brave to share your story, as we all have one. I enjoyed you sharing this with us today. God continue to bless you. Never easy. You are so right, Lynn. Live in your truth and live your best life. That should be on a plaque in my house. It honestly should, because that is a great, 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 great motto. Always live in your truth. And I do. I don't deny where I come from. I don't deny my past. I don't forget about my past. I look forward to the future and I live in the present. But every day I try to live my best life and be my true authentic self. That's a great, great, great saying. Like I said, that should be put on I have to maybe put that on a plaque in my house. I have to, but thank you so much, Lynn.
Oh, Cooking with Judy
Caldwell again. I haven't known you that long, but you are approachable, hilarious, and so full of energy, and happy anniversary to you both. Thank you so much, Judy. Thank you so, so, so much. And I hope, Judy, in these videos, you get to know me even more, but thank you so much. I try to be approachable. I try to be funny in my own way, and I try to be full of energy. Lady Luck, good morning, love. Good morning, Lady Luck. Shell Eats, happy day, Dante. Great topic. This is so true. It's a double standard people make. It is as if a girl plays with balls, she's okay, but if a boy plays with dolls, he needs some counseling because he's confused. I completely agree. It is so, like, backwards. Like, I don't understand it. Like, JB and myself are not having children. But if I did, my dream was always to have a little boy and a little girl. That was always my dream. Twins. I always wanted, but, you know, it's not happening. But if I ever saw my son playing with a Barbie I wouldn't think anything of it. I think also you're ruining the kid's imagination. Who cares if he wants to play with a baby doll or Barbies or whatever? I think about that sometimes, how when we were younger, we had such imaginations. We had such, like, we could make a room feel like a pirate ship. You know, you could make the backyard be a jungle, and you lose that over time, and never take that away from a child. If he wants to play with a damn Barbie, let him play with it. Let him use his imagination, because guess what? One day it's going to be gone. It's going to be gone. And that is just, oh, I hate thinking about it. But yes, Shell Eats, you're so right. It is a double standard. It's so ridiculous. So ridiculous. And thank you for commenting, Shell Eats. I love you, Shell. Next up is from Jody Tomorrow. Dante, I love the video. I'm happy you are feeling better now. Thank you, Jody. I love you, Jody. Jody watches every single one of my videos. She comments on every single one of my videos. Thank you, Jody. And I am feeling better. Guys, with this whole, like, sorbitol allergy, it is so hard to... And that was kind of part of me being sick was the stomach bug, was this sorbitol allergy. I never realized how many fruits, vegetables, foods have sorbitol in it. It is crazy. JB today was going to make an apple pie, and I was so excited for it because we found an apple peeler in our cabinets. I didn't even know we had an apple peeler. He said, did you buy this at the thrift store? I said, no, I've never even seen an apple peeler in the thrift store. So no, it must have come from my mother-in-law, but it was way back in the cabinet. And guess what? Apples have sorbitol in them. What the hell? What the hell? But thank you, Jody. Next up is from my auntie, Ginger. Snap 44. Ooh, this is a long one. Hold on real quick. Young man, I am so proud of you. You brought tears of joy to me today. I love that you get to be exactly who God made you to be, and what a beautiful soul you are. My cousin Scott is gay, and his story is truly so sad. We were born and raised in a time where it was to be kept quiet for the fear of being beat up or hurt. We were raised in the church, and his mama literally said the meanest things to him. He is now 48 years old and just now being very open about being who he is and true to himself. And it's such a beautiful thing to see him truly happy. He has taught me so much. And in this big old world we live in, somebody or someone will always find fault with you. So I say F them and feed them fish heads. Yes, that's right. And be who you want to be. I've never seen a thing wrong with homosexuality, and I'm a big old tomboy. I always have been, but you're correct. It is a double standard for girls and boys, which makes no sense to me. It makes no sense to me either, Auntie. It makes no sense to me. I love men. I love sex. Does that make me a pig? Auntie, you're getting me cursing here. Okay, hold on. Does that make me a big blank? No, not at all. I just enjoy a healthy sex life with... I am not reading that. I'm like blushing. Oh my God. Okay, I'll let you read that if you just want to. This is fun to me, but shameful to others. I'm so thankful you married your best friend, and guess what? I love you bunches and bunches. I'm so thankful that God put us together in this big old world, and I'm happy to have a loving, fun nephew who acts a lot like his Auntie Jin. Auntie Jin, you know I love you so, so much. I was actually just messaging you last night and this morning, but I'm so sorry to hear that about your cousin Scott, but I'm so happy that even at that age, he's still able. There's still time. And y'all, you know, I mean,
I don't even know what I'm trying to say,
but there is still time. And that's such a beautiful thing that now he could live a happy, wonderful life. And, you know, even at 48 years old, it's still beautiful. Be open, be comfortable in your skin. It took me a very long time. I mean, look at me. I mean, it took me a very long time to be who I want to be. And I walk into the store with a purse. I walk into the store with makeup on, long, fabulous hair. I don't care anymore. I just don't care. I'm happy. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Especially to strangers that like to say stuff. Leave me alone. I'm not talking to you. I'm not looking at you. Like, just let me go in the store, get what I need. That's what I do. I go in the store, I get what I need, and I want to leave. I don't want to engage. I really don't. I really don't. But Auntie Ginge, you know I love you so much, and we are two peas in a pod. I have to say that. We are definitely two peas in a pod, but I love you so, so much, and you are too funny. I am not saying those words on this YouTube, but I will let y'all read it. But you know I love you so, so much, so, so much. I appreciate your friendship, and I love you just oodles and oodles, and I was telling JB last night how much I love you, so you know you are loved. I don't want to make this video too long, guys. I'm trying. Limitless by V. Lenore. Oh, I love you. I love her. Love hearing your story. Thank you for sharing it. Love your response to the big bully. So, exactly. I turned right around to her when she called me the F word, and I went, so? Oh, my God. Do you know the weight that was lifted off my shoulders, y'all? It was amazing. It was amazing. Happy earlier belated anniversary. Thank you so much, Limitless by V. Lenore. I love you, girl. I love her. She cracks me the hell up. She is so funny. And Judy Caldwell is on here. She's replying to everybody's comment. Thank you, Judy. She's like putting hearts under everybody's thing. Thank you so much, Judy. I've been noticing that as I'm reading them. Judy, you're the best. Thank you. She's like putting hearts under everybody's thing, guys. And like I said, I didn't want you to think that I wasn't commenting back. I just was saving it for this video. Mama Vapes Beauty, happy day, Dante. Happy day, Beth. Happy day. Oh, there's my girl, Angelina. I am so proud of you for sharing your story. It really helped shine the light on the subject for all of us that have come out or are still struggling to come out. It makes me so happy I was the first one you told. Only lonelies for life. That's right, Ange. Lonely onlys for life. Or only lonelies for life. I want to get us jackets or something. Guys, if you don't know what only lonelies mean, me and Angelina, or Angelina and myself, are only children. I do have step siblings and I have a half brother, but most of my life I was only lonely, and so was Ange. That's a big reason why we connected so much. I just love her. We get each other. I love Angelina. I need to see her soon. She started a new job. I need to see her soon. We need to catch up and cook again in the kitchen. We need to. But you know I love you. I'm so happy we have reconnected. True friendships can always get through any gaps of time. Love you, dude. You know I love you. Me and Angelina were very close friends, and then there was a gap. And about, I want to say, 2 or 3 years ago, me and Angelina reconnected, and I'm the luckiest guy in the whole entire world. I love her. I love her friendship. I appreciate it. She is someone that I could just be around for hours and hours and be myself and just have a great time. She was over a couple weeks ago. We made cauliflower buffalo wings, but they were like cauliflower and you bread them and you like bake them and stuff, and they were delicious. But we were in my kitchen. JB was in here watching a movie. We were in the kitchen and we were cooking and having a blast, just venting and talking. And oh, I loved it. It was so much fun. I can't wait to do it again. And Angelina, you know I love you. Rome's Eating and Conversations, good morning, happy day. Again, good morning and happy day, everybody. Life with Team Velez, hello friends, sending full support. See you around, stay connected. And Mr. Jimmy Vega, happy anniversary, way better on the other side. Guess what? When you do, yes, Mr. Jimmy Vega, when you, like, that's the whole thing, is like, when you are closeted, it is such a relief off your shoulders when you finally do come out. It's like, when I would see, like, those ads of, like, it gets better, you know, like, those ads of, like, LGBTQ+ people saying that, or it gets better, I never believed it, but guess what it does? It's better when you, it's just, like, a weight, and you're happy, and you love being who you are, and, you know, to the people that can't be that way, and even, like, Auntie Ginger's cousin, you know, it sucks, but there still is time. There still is time. There still is time. But, guys, I just want to thank you all for commenting. Thank you so much for your support. You guys are all so, so great, and I didn't want you just to think that I was ignoring you. I wanted to do this, so Wednesday when this goes up, I'll go in, and I'm going to heart everybody's, but I hope I got to live comment and, you know, connect with y'all a little bit more, and not just sit here and talk about, I don't know, nothing, you know? I wanted to live react and definitely show y'all that I appreciate y'all and I appreciate your support. And I don't mean like YouTube support. I mean like support just of me and my family and just everything. And just know I love yous all from the bottom of my heart.
Guys, this salad.
All right, guys, I am 28 minutes in. I have to cut this video down a little bit. I have to. I don't want you to sit in here for 28 minutes watching it. So I'm going to go edit this video. Guys, again, I just wanted to live react and share, you know, read the comments on my coming out video, because it was a really great time to share my story with y'all. It really was. I loved it. But guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for having lunch with me today. Guys, if there's any other topics you would like me to talk about, please leave them below down in the comments. I'd love to talk about any topic that you would like me to discuss. So please leave them down below. And guys, if you would, please like, subscribe, comment down below. Even though I'm the worst commenter backer in the whole entire world, I do try. Ring that little bell. Every time you do, you'll be notified every time I upload new content. And guys, again, know that I love you from the bottom of my heart. I appreciate every single one of y'all. Just appreciate every single one of y'all. And I hope I didn't miss anyone's comments. That's the comments that came up. I hope I didn't miss anybody's. If I did, I'll try to add it in while I'm editing. But just know I love you from the bottom of my heart. And until next time, bye-bye.